Hello everyone, and thank you for joining us at DayTradeToWin for the next video in how to use the SuperDOM on NinjaTrader 8. We do get a lot of questions on how to use the SuperDOM, so I thought it would be a good idea to create this video in demonstrating how to use the SuperDOM on your NinjaTrader 8 application. Now, all these videos can be found on the DayTradeToWin.org, DayTradeToWin.net.com, the blog. So we have a few resources available for traders who want to learn how to trade, how price action works, and this video will concentrate and focus on the SuperDOM. Now to begin, we're going to open up a SuperDOM by going to the NinjaTrader Control Center, clicking New, and choosing SuperDOM. When you open up the SuperDOM, it's going to have here a market that you have to link before you're able to place your trades. Whether it's in SIM or a live account, you have to choose a market. So you'd come here and you would choose whatever market you're interested in looking at, E-mini, Euro, crude oil, whatever the case may be. Make sure that the market corresponds with the chart that you're looking at. So if you're looking at a chart of the 1 minute E-mini chart, it should be an E-mini instrument on the dome as well, on the SuperDOM. Now to place orders, there are three different types of orders that you're probably going to start working with. The most common is going to be a market order, where you enter either as a buyer or enter as a seller directly at the current market price. You could expect a tick of slippage under normal circumstances on the E-mini S&P. You may get a better price or you may get the exact price, but always expect about a tick of slippage just to make sure you account for market orders. So if you enter as a buyer, you'd click here on the left column as a buyer to enter.
Order filled.
And the ATM strategy takes care of the targets and the stops. We'll cover that in a later video.
Order filled.
Or as a seller, you come here on this column. Down here it says market. You would click on that market button and you're selling.
Order filled.
Directly at the market price.
Order filled.
Another order that you could choose, which is a limit order. I like to use limit orders because the definition of a limit order says I want this exact price or better. So as a buyer, you always place a limit order here on the left column, the buy column, below where the market is currently trading. Left click, it says, do you want to buy a limit order at this price?
Order pending.
And you would click yes to accept it. The same thing, but the opposite.
Order canceled.
Here on the right column is a sell above the market to say, I want this exact price or better. So the market has to retrace up in order to.
Order pending.
Fill you short on a limit at this price or better. So if it touches this price, there's no guarantee that you're actually going to be filled. If it goes through the price, then everyone at this price was filled and the market moves on to the next price here up on the ladder, on the dome.
Order canceled.
Limit order can be an entry or an exit, just like a market order can be an entry or an exit. The other order is a stop order. And a stop order basically allows you to use as an entry as the market is moving in the same direction, or as a stop order, commonly known as a protective stop, to get you out at a loss. So a stop order, use the middle mouse button and press down on the wheel in order to create what you see here as a stop. This particularly is a stop with a limit. It's an advanced order that allows you to limit the amount of slippage. If you want no slippage whatsoever, when buying as the market moves up in the same direction, you're saying, I want this price or nothing. If you are willing to accept one tick of slippage, then it's going to allow you to go long at this price or this price. The same thing is true if you use a sell. You're placing the sell order as the market is going down and down and down, either as an entry or as a protective stop loss. If you are already long and you want to protect yourself because the market's going against you, you would use this stop order. And so if you want to exit the market or enter the market at this price, you would say, I want this price or nothing. I want one tick of slippage, two tick of slippage. This does not mean number of contracts. Number of contracts, the quantity is down here. Now, the other way that you could use a stop order is just a basic stop, not using this advanced system, which is a stop with a limit. NinjaTrader defaults to a stop with a limit when you click the middle mouse button. But if you hold down the control key on your keyboard and then press the middle mouse button, the wheel, what you have is just a regular stop. A regular stop is what most of you are accustomed to, which is a stop order typically converts into a market order. Again, remember the one tick of slippage possibly when it hits your stop, which converts into a market.
Order pending.
So a stop order can get you into the market as a seller for the first time, or can get you out of the market if you are already long and the market's going against you. The same thing is true here.
Order canceled.
As a buy stop to enter
order
the market.
Pending.
You're entering the market as the price continues to go up and up and up. You're going long in the same direction, unlike a limit order, which is a retracement. And once you're filled, then you have your stops and your targets added to the chart.
Order canceled.
Lastly, we have market of touch, something new with NinjaTrader 8. If you hold down the control key and use it, left click limit order, but it's a market of touch. So let's say I want to go long on a limit order. Remember, the market has to retrace buy side below where it's trading. Hold down the control key and you see buy MIT, market if touched. Basically, this is a way
pending.
To ensure that you get filled if it just touches your price instead of touching and bouncing off of it, and you're not filled when it touches the price, which happens a lot both on entries and exits. So this is a market if touched as a buyer entering on a retracement.
Order canceled.
Or a market if touched as a seller.
Order pending.
Which could either be entering for the first time or exiting as a profit target. So when you enter into the market, what
order
you see
filled.
Is a stop and a target. This is still a stop order, which if you're selling the market and it's now moving up in the long position, you're getting stopped out long as it moves up. And this is your target, which is a limit order. The same is true
order filled.
If you used a entry as a buyer.
Order pending.
Market if touched. So as soon as it touches, you're filled. And once you're filled, the targets and
order filled.
The stops are here. This is your target, which now the market is going up. And you want the market to go higher. You want to get out at a higher price to make a profit. Or you're selling at a loss as the market is coming down. This is a stop order. You can also place these orders manually. You don't have to use the ATM strategy.
Order filled.
If you come here and you choose none, it's really the same thing. You can, let's say, buy at market or buy in a stop or buy in a limit.
Order filled.
You're officially long. Then you have to come into the market and place a limit order.
Order pending.
As a profit target, or it could be a market if touched.
Order pending.
As well, so if it touches that, you're out. Basically, they do the same thing. The limit order, this exact price or better or nothing. Market if touched says, once it touches this price, you're taken out of the market at whatever price it can get you. Sometimes it's the exact price, better price, a tick of slippage. Market if touched converts to a market. And don't forget about the stop, middle mouse button.
Order pending.
It's also moving in the same direction down, losing money. You're getting out at a stop loss. These orders can also be moved around, so you can click on them, left click, and move them around very easily. But remember, electronic trading is first come, first serve, which means that if you move, especially the limit order, not so much the market if touched or the stop order, but the limit order, if you move this around, you're always placed at the back of the line. A stop order doesn't matter, converts to a market. A market if touched doesn't matter, converts to a market. Hopefully you have an understanding on how to use the SuperDOM, which is also called the Matrix in TradeStation, price ladder. Really, it's all the same thing. What you're seeing is placing orders on the SuperDOM. You can also use the chart trader if you're accustomed to that. I like the SuperDOM. We have more videos available on how to trade the markets, including access to free software. Visit DayTradeToWin.com, check out the next mentorship class, and email us or call us with any questions you may have.